What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Brews and Reviews. My phone is ringing. Kidding me? I'm gonna get that later. Welcome to another episode of Brews and Reviews here at Frontenac Cycle, where we sip on beers and talk about bike products. I'm Rob Whalen, normally behind the camera, but I'm sitting here on a kicker box, trainer box, sitting with André, shop mechanic. Say what's up.
Yeah. So you guys may think that we're going to be talking about trainers today, but it's actually a different Wahoo product. We're going to be talking about the Wahoo Elelemnt Bolt GPS computer.
Oh yeah. And let's not forget the beers. That's a big part of this show. We've got some beers from Spearhead, Kingston Brewer. I'm just going to...
I'm pre-cracked.
Ooh, nice. Whoa, oh boy. Got a little foam there. This is my go-to beer in the city. Nice little citrus IPA. It's a classic. I like to sip on it. Andre's already got one going. Should we talk about this computer?
Yeah.
So a quick overview on what we're going to talk about today. This is a review by riders for the average rider. There are so many reviews of this product online. So if you want to get into the super nerdy detail about all the little things, there are reviews for that. We're going to kind of glaze over some of the stuff that we think is important for the average rider. So we're not going to get into the like minutia of everything. We are going to talk about the mount. We're going to talk about the size of the computer. We're going to talk about the screen a little bit. We're going to talk about battery life, among a few other things. So I hope you enjoy what we're going to throw at you.
So this computer actually comes with two different ways to mount onto your handlebar. Which one do you prefer?
Yeah, good question. So like you said, it comes with two. Here they are right here. Comes with this little round guy that sits right on the bar. Comes with the zip ties, throw it right on there. And it comes with this arrow mount. Sits out in front of the stem. I don't prefer one or the other. Actually, I use them both, and so I'm kind of pumped that Wahoo did include them both. This one goes on my gravel bike. I like how it kind of sits out in front of the stem in that it just ergonomically it works for me. I can see the screen and I'm paying a little more attention to the data as I'm riding on the gravel bike or on the road, but I don't ride a ton of road. That doesn't matter. Same kind of setup. And then I put this one on my mountain bike. Just sits on the bar, super simple. I'm not looking at the computer while I'm ripping through the trees.
Of course.
Not a good idea, but it's there nonetheless. So I kind of like that, yeah.
Nice, awesome. Well, another tip about this arrow mount is it's actually 12.6 seconds faster over a 40 kilometer time trial than its competitor.
There you go, coming at you with the data. How's that Hawaiian style pale ale going?
I'm a big fan. It's very fruity. Kind of transports you to a warmer place than Kingston.
Yeah. So I mean, even when it's snowing, when it's full summer, this is my go-to from Spearhead.
Oh, is it? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay. So back to the Wahoo Elelemnt Bolt. This has the capability of loading maps, tracking things by GPS, turn by turn, all that kind of stuff. I know you've used it a bunch on some longer trips, so it would be sweet if you could sort of tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely. So yeah, I've used the Elelemnt Bolt on both of my Central Ontario loop trail bikepacking trips. Mm-hmm. I found it was extremely seamless getting my GPS routes loaded in and getting turn by turn navigation, which is super useful when you're somewhere that you're unfamiliar with.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. And can you zoom right in to like an intersection, or are you looking at like big picture, like?
Absolutely, any range you want, you can zoom right in to your intersection, or you can zoom out and see your entire 500K loop. And to load loops onto the computer, it's actually super easy. It's just through the Wahoo app. Mm-hmm. Super seamless, super easy.
Cool. So let's just say you're kind of a dinosaur. Maybe you're not doing everything on your phone all the time. Can you load maps on there from your laptop, desktop, computer?
You actually can. So you can load .gpx files.
Okay.
Straight from your computer, which you can get on Bike with GPS or some websites like that.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Well, there you go. So this thing's got rubber buttons all around. There isn't a hole to be seen. I've ridden through some rain, snow, all sorts of conditions with this. Never fails. What about you?
Yeah, same here. I absolutely have made it through lots of rain with my Elelemnt. No issues. Very waterproof. Definitely good to be able to rely on that.
Yeah, maybe we're not jumping in a lake with it, but if you're doing that on a bike, you got other things to think
about.
Right.
That's right.
There is a waterfall on my favorite trail, a mountain bike, Kingston. Definitely rode through that. Mm-hmm. It was fine. It's all good. So kudos to Wahoo for their getting those seams tight. And just to further that, this is the, so we're going to talk about the sensors a little bit. This isn't the sensor talk, but I did want to point out that this is my cadence sensor that I actually pulled off my crank today because I put my bike on the trainer and I don't need two cadence sensors because it's built into that one. but it is covered in dirt. It's gone through puddles, ridden in rain. That thing has never failed. So I would say that the kit as a whole,
I think it is designed to be water resistant at the very least.
Yeah,
for sure.
For sure.
Yeah.
All right. So in our previous cut, I tossed the lob ball about the sensors. So I'm going to hit it over to you and you can tell us about some of the goodies you can add to your bolt.
Absolutely. Yes. I mean, you have the option of buying the Elelemnt bolt just on its own mm-hmm. as a computer unit, but you can also purchase it as a bundle. With a bunch of sensors. So one of those sensors is the Wahoo speed sensor. And essentially what this is gonna allow is a much more accurate speed and distance reading.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically for mountain bikers, this is a great thing to have because you're gonna be cutting tight corners, you're in the trees, GPS signal's probably not gonna be that great. So this allows you to have much more accurate readouts.
Yeah, and let's be honest, these things are not important for the everyday rider, but I love data, and so if I'm give or take 2K from my buddy's ride, that kind of bugs me a little bit. So yeah. I want to know how long my ride actually was. So especially on the mountain bike, I do like that. Mounts right to the hub.
Absolutely.
With this fancy little elastic band, you just kind of wrap that around. No tools required. I've been on this with two seasons and the rubber's still good. So good quality build there.
Yeah, absolutely. Next up, we've got the Wahoo cadence sensor. This is also a good one for mountain biking because it basically tells your computer when you're pedaling. So, you know, rather than having the GPS signal decide when you're moving or not, the cadence will work with the speed sensor
mm-hmm.
to kind of come up with a better calculation for when you're going to start moving.
So, that's good. I don't actually have that on my mountain bike. I only keep it on my gravel bike because I always thought, hey, I don't actually care what my cadence is on the mountain bike because I'm coasting most of the time.
Yeah, it's all just going to lead to more accurate data.
There you go. Wahoo's got it figured out. Now I need to buy another one.
That's right. Moving on, we've got heart rate sensors. You've actually got two options for these. Rob prefers the armband sensor.
I do.
Personally, I prefer the chest sensor. So, Rob, I mean, tell me why do you prefer the armband over the chest?
Just a comfort thing. I'm used to wearing a watch, so it's just like, it's just there and I can see it. And if it moves around on the ride, I can just give it a little, you know.
Right.
But I feel like with the chest mount, for me, it's uncomfortable and kind of, I don't really love it. But for you, like for your experience with the chest sensor, does it move around on you at all?
Yeah, I mean, I've had a great experience with the chest sensor. I definitely haven't found that it moves around a bunch. I find it's definitely, you know, you can set it loose enough that it's not going to be restricting your breathing or anything
mm-hmm.
like that. And you don't want to make it tight enough though that it's bugging you and stuff like that, but
right.
I can't speak for the armband. I haven't actually used it, but
yeah, the only thing I would say about the armband is on more like rugged trails, and I find this more on my gravel bike because there's no suspension, obviously. When I get into some like kind of washboard, I do find it moves around a little bit, and I have to adjust it, but it's right there, so I can do it. But for the most part, it stays put. So
mm-hmm.
yeah, I'm happy with it.
Yeah, I think that's about it for sensors.
We've talked about the sensors for the everyday rider. What about the person who's training for triathlon or O Cup, whatever? How important and effective are these things, you know, in combination, obviously, with the computer?
Yeah, I mean, I'd say absolutely the most important sensor to have is a heart rate sensor.
Mm-hmm.
Being able to gauge your efforts, you know what zone you're in, do zone-based training, and also when you're actually in a race, knowing how far into your threshold you are, you know, mm-hmm. how many batteries you've got left.
Yeah.
Super important data to have if you're going to be getting serious.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Another way you can get serious is with the Wahoo cadence sensor, knowing what speed your legs are actually spinning at while you're riding.
Yeah, I mean, that's an important one for me, even on everyday gravel rides. I know that for me personally, staying in that 90 to 100 RPM is my sweet spot. So, I mean, from a training perspective or even in a race, seeing where you're at as you're going is very helpful data. Yeah. Like you said, the batteries, you gotta that's make right. sure you've got enough left to finish the ride.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
And then hand in hand, speed and cadence are working together, obviously.
Yeah, I'd say speed is also really important. You know, if specifically, like we said earlier, if you're mountain biking, it's gonna give you much more accurate distance readouts and speed readouts when you're in the woods.
Right. So you gotta have the computer, but you gotta have the kit.
That's right.
All right.
That's right.
So not only is this thing integrating with all these sensors, it's got Bluetooth. It's integrating with your phone. So let's just say I'm riding along. I get a text. What's gonna happen?
Well, your text will actually pop right up onto your Wahoo Elelemnt computer.
Okay.
As well as your phone calls. And I believe you can select to have emails show up as well.
I would turn that off.
Yeah, definitely.
Let's not get emails on the trail. But texts, okay, that's good. I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so, the more things that this does, the more battery it's going to use.
That's right.
Is that a big deal?
I mean, so you've got about 15 hours of battery life with this. Mm-hmm. I found I can stretch that out to at least a week, if not 2 weeks, you know, with an hour or 2 hour ride a few times a week. Definitely feels like it never dies.
I rarely charge mine. It's not like my phone that I put on the dock every night. This thing, I'm just like, hey, I haven't charged this in a while. Just plug it in before my ride so it doesn't
check
die halfway through. Yeah,
that's right.
And it's like, oh, it's at 26%. I've done 5 rides. So battery life, not a huge concern, but, you know, gotta plug it in once in a while.
Your battery life definitely will go down quicker if it's connected to your phone, though.
Yes.
So, Rob, we've talked about lots of the features about the Elelemnt Bolt. Mm-hmm. What are some things that you like or dislike about it?
Likes and dislikes. I definitely like how easy it is to use, how seamless it is. I previously was using my Apple Watch before that my phone to upload to Strava, but this thing, I love that I come in from a ride, I push stop, it's there.
Instant.
It's done, it's instant, like super seamless. I love that. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Okay. And what about things that you dislike?
One thing, only one, and it's the buttons. Buttons on the main surface are fine, but the side buttons, I find the tactile, you know, they're not, I feel like I really need to center my finger on the button to feel like I'm actually pushing it and feel the click. Mm. So that would be a nice upgrade in version 2, which is sitting right there.
Yeah.
That's did they right. fix that?
They did.
They actually did fix that.
They did. So in the newest version of the Elelemnt Bolt GPS, they've actually released a color display and easier to click buttons.
Yes, color display. Good call. So this one is black and white.
That's right.
Not a deal breaker for me, but it's nice. Nice to have color screen, you know, keep up with the times, so that's kind of cool. Maybe taking a note from the Rome.
Yeah, that's right. And I mean, the things I like about the computer, probably one of my favorite features is the fact that you can actually sync your real world rides to your trainer with the computer. So it'll match your elevation profile, your speed, or sorry, not your speed, but your distance and your route and all that can be simulated on your Wahoo trainer.
That's very cool, especially where we live, where it's winter out. It's nice for especially roadies who are not out there on their fat bikes riding the trails all winter long, so they can recreate those like awesome Sunday morning rides in their basement in the pain cave.
Yeah, that's right.
any dislikes for you?
I mean, honestly,
no dislikes.
Really can't think of any. Okay. I've had the same Wahoo Elelemnt Bolt for almost 5 years and it hasn't let me down.
There you go. That's a pitch if I've ever heard one.
That's right.
Thank you so much for tuning into our review of the Wahoo Elelemnt Bolt for the everyday mountain, road, and gravel rider. I know I certainly enjoyed hanging out, drinking a Hawaiian style with you, André.
So did I. And I mean, if you're looking to try out this beer that we've been drinking today, you can get it at the beer store, LCBO, or you can load the route to Spearhead right into your Wahoo Elelemnt GPS Bolt computer and bike over yourself.
Follow those turn-by-turn instructions. Get there, get some Spearhead. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
All right, if you enjoyed that video, make sure to hammer that like button and subscribe, because we've got more coming to you. Thank you very much.
I had my YouTube voice on?
Yeah, yeah.
Shit.
It's like, why is he talking to me with his YouTube voice on?